The last day will not be established until earthquakes will be very frequent. In the previous section, we looked at the disasters that have struck big cities and saw how such disasters, both man-made in the form of war and natural disasters, have destroyed whole cities. When we examine these natural disasters a little more closely, another portent of doom emerges before our eyes. That is the earthquake so frequently stressed in the Hadith. According to American National Earthquake Information Center figures, there have been 20,832 earthquakes on Earth in 1999 alone, during which tens of thousands of people have lost their lives. The number and intensity of earthquakes is increasing. Once more demonstrating the truth of the news of the end times revealed in the Hadith. The poor will grow in number. Gains will be shared out only among the rich, with no benefit to the poor. As the last day draws near, these hadiths revealing that poverty and high costs of living will assume much greater dimensions are rapidly coming true in the present day. Many people in Africa, Asia, South America, and Eastern Europe are staring hunger in the face. Researchers into this subject reveal that one quarter of the world's population, or some 1.5 billion people, live under conditions of inconceivable misery and poverty. According to the figures, for the year 2000, 826 million people in the world are undernourished. In other words, one out of every six people is starving. But why? Is it because there are not enough resources? No. The unfair and unjust distribution of capital among the people of the world means that only a very few people are able to benefit from the world's resources, while hundreds of millions of others are condemned to hunger, poverty, and misery. Furthermore, the scale of this inequality has been on the rise since the beginning of the 20th century. One of the most important reasons for this tragic picture is that people have turned as far away as possible from listening to the dictates of their consciences and all forms of human and ethical values.